川普身上背负着90几项罪名，34项重罪，加上1月6号在2021年时候他攻击国会大厦涉嫌的这个相关的案子，或者是他过去的谎言，他的风格，这样的人要当选美国总统几乎是不可能。可是从2016年开始，他就是美国一大群人的英雄，而且这些一大群人过去很多是民主党的铁票区，这些人所以转向不只是共和党，而且是转向川普，很大的一个原因跟民主党的治理失败，跟美国长期的治理失败是有关系的。我们以芝加哥这个城市作为例子，为大家做出相关的报道。
截至9月1号为止，芝加哥今年已有近400人死于凶杀案，其中90%是中弹身亡。讽刺的是，芝加哥过去93年以来都是由主张加强枪支管制的民主党人治理，也难怪当民主党选择在芝加哥召开全国党代表大会时，共和党对手就像捡到枪，毫不犹豫痛批民主党的失败之作。
And it's almost a joke to me that they held it in Chicago, which has become the murder capital of the United States of America, thanks to very failed Democrat leadership.My little theory about why they decided to have the convention in Chicago is, you know, Tim Walz has been going around saying that he served in war, and maybe they did it in Chicago so that he could actually accurately say that he visited a combat zone.
其实民主党没有避开芝加哥的枪支暴力问题，他们在 DNC 大会上邀请包括芝加哥市民在内的多名大规模枪击案目击者发言。民主党主张加强枪支管控，才能避免更多枪击犯罪事件。指控是共和党阻挡立法，共和党则是主张必须加强执法才能够吓阻不法分子犯罪，还说民主党弱化警力。但芝加哥的治安问题没这么简单，要解释问题的根源必须从100年前说起。当时许多非裔美国人因为受不了南方的种族隔离政策而选择北上，但没想到芝加哥的种族歧视问题又是另一种状况。
Ida B. Wells, who is a noted activist, journalist, said Chicago was beginning to rival the Jim Crow South in its treatment of the Negro.
1920年代末期开始，全美各地爆发了多起种族冲突事件，大多数是白人攻击非裔美国人。芝加哥和华府等城市则有黑人反击，导致大量死伤。这些冲突事件催生种族歧视住屋政策。当时的非裔公民难以获得购物贷款，买得起房子的被迫接受高房价和利息，买不起的人则是很容易就因违反租屋规定而被房东赶走。以非裔族群为主的社区，过去数十年不是因为高速公路计划被迫拆迁，不然就是因为社宅盖了又拆，世世代代难以拥有自己的家。
We're talking about a $3 to $4 billion wealth gap between white Chicagoans and black Chicagoans that's directly tied to the inability to develop equity from housing. Some of the fundamental things that help keep people safe are the ability to provide social support for each other, their ability to have beliefs on what they think their community should look like, and their ability to use their collective power.To enforce those beliefs. What you're doing is that you're disrupting the very things in terms of how people can support each other, which creates conditions for violence.
芝加哥非裔社区失业率是其他社区的2倍，犯罪率更是高达3倍。长期研究犯罪根源的科西盖说，芝加哥执政者没有解决根本问题，只会增加警力，以暴制暴。
It is basically a process that keeps repeating itself. It has a new face.The United States government in itself is complicit, and we need to address that.
学者的意思是，不管民主党或共和党政府都没有拿出消除暴力犯罪的有效方法。芝加哥人也意识到这一点，知道自己的家园得靠自己来救。科尔在2015年成立公益组织，帮助非裔社区青年走出恶性循环。他的组织动员居民重建社区。让青少年攻读当导游，向游客讲解芝加哥的历史，也增强他们的身份认同感，并找到努力的目标。
I want to do the very most and prove everyone that doubted those black boys that's coming from the community and show them that it is possible.